Hey everyone, my name is Ryan Wold, and I'm a Senior Support Escalation Engineer on the Surface Hub support team at Microsoft. In this video, we'll be going over what's new with 20H2 on the Surface Hub. The new features available with 20H2 and its subsequent updates are documented in our Administrator Guide under the Surface Hub 2S Overview tab, and then What's New in Windows 10 Team 2020 Update. I'd recommend looking over the entirety of this page to fully understand everything that's new. What we'll be covering in this video is modern authentication, how to enable non-global admins to sign into settings, the new Teams client, as well as the new Edge browser, and the ability to migrate a Surface Hub to run full Windows 10 or 11. Let's begin by taking a quick look at modern authentication, and we'll start by signing into settings. The main requirement for the Surface Hub to use Modern Auth is the device account needs to authenticate using Azure Active Directory, the mailbox needs to be hosted in Exchange Online, and the account needs to be added in the UPN format. With the 20H2 update, the Surface Hub now uses Exchange Web Services instead of basic authentication with ActiveSync. If you'd like to learn more about modern authentication on the Surface Hub and how to disable it for unsupported environments, you can watch an in-depth video I made on the topic, which is linked in the video description. Another new feature added with the 20H2 update is support for non-global admins to sign into settings on an Azure AD Join Surface Hub. Prior to this update, only global administrators could sign into settings. Now, we have the ability to deploy a local users and groups policy to the Surface Hub. This will modify the membership of the local administrators group on the device, so members of a security group will have permissions to sign into settings. I'll navigate to the non-global admin configuration section within our documentation to highlight a few things. The first is, in order for this policy to work, the Surface Hub must be Azure AD joined and Intune auto-enrolled. Auto-enrollment means the device was enrolled into Intune during the Azure AD join process within UBI. If a Surface Hub was manually enrolled into Intune through settings, do not deploy the security group to these devices, as it may break the ability to sign into settings altogether. I'll scroll down to the bottom of this page for an important note. After deploying this policy to the Surface Hub, global administrators will no longer be able to sign into settings, unless they're members of the security group that was used. Now let's walk through what the configuration looks like once it's set up. I'll head to the Azure AD portal and click on Groups. Here, I've created a security group called Surface Hub Local Admins. The members of this group are users that I want to be able to sign into settings on the hub. I've also included my global admin account so it doesn't lose access. On the properties page of this group is the object ID. Keep note of this, as you'll need it later on when configuring the policy. Going back to the Azure AD groups, you can see we also have a group called Surface Hub Devices. The members of this are Intune-enrolled Surface Hubs I'll be deploying this non-global admin policy to. Notice, the members of this group are the Surface Hub device objects, not the device account that's used for conferencing. Let's move over to Endpoint Manager, where I'll show you how this policy is set up. Click Devices on the left, then Configuration Profiles. Here, I created a profile called Local Admin Group on Surface Hub. I'll click Properties, and then Edit under Configuration Settings. I'll then edit this custom OMA URI. This is where you'll add a custom XML file that contains the security group of the users you want to be able to sign into settings. This is the SID, which was created by converting the object ID of the Surface Hub Local Admin security group. Here, we have the custom OMA URI used to configure the local users and groups policy. I'll cancel out of these. Back on the main properties page of this profile, you can see I have this assigned to the Surface Hub Devices group. So now, a non-global admin can sign into settings on the Surface Hub. Something else new with the 20H2 update is the new Teams Rooms on Surface Hub client, which is based on the desktop Electron app. This new Teams client offers a bunch of great new features, like reactions, large gallery view, PowerPoint Live, Teams Coordinated Meetings, and Proximity Join. If you'd like to take a closer look at all these new features and capabilities, I'd recommend watching the video I made on the new Teams Rooms on Surface Hub client, which I've linked in the description below. Another exciting new feature with Windows 10 Team 2020 Update 1 is the new Edge browser, which is based on Chromium, is now installed by default. We also have a number of new Edge CSPs that can be applied for more granular control of the browser experience on the Surface Hub. The last feature I want to highlight is specific to the Surface Hub 2S. We now have the ability to migrate the device to run the full Windows desktop experience. The Surface Hub 2S will continue to come pre-installed with Windows 10 Team Edition, which provides an immersive collaboration experience that allows anyone to walk up to and use the device. For customers who want to optimize their experience for personal use, while having the ability to run 32 and 64-bit applications, migrating to Windows 10 or 11, Pro or Enterprise, may be beneficial. Another cool feature for devices migrated to full Windows is they can utilize the Surface Hub 2 fingerprint reader to sign in using Windows Hello. This fingerprint reader was designed specifically for the Surface Hub 2S USB-C ports, so it sits flush against the device and matches in color. Once installed and configured, you simply press your finger to it and Windows will sign you in. And that covers some of the new features available with the Windows 10 Team 2020 update. Thanks so much for watching.